Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of the Fantasy Football Fallout. It's where I watch every play of every game of every week, trying to find you the fantasy football diamonds in the rough. Today I am talking about the Carolina Panthers versus the Arizona Cardinals, a game that was interesting because we didn't know what to expect from Carolina Panthers quarterback Kyle Allen coming into the game. How was Carolina going to respond? The answer is they responded quite well. I'll talk about Arizona in just a bit. I gotta say, Kyle Allen was moving this offense. He showed accuracy, he showed precision. His stat line, 19 completions on only 26 passing attempts. But when you have Christian McCaffrey running the ball 24 times for over 150 yards, that helps a young quarterback. Second year player, went to a couple of different colleges. I gotta say, man, he came out of nowhere. I didn't know a lot about him, as I'm sure a lot of fans outside of Carolina probably didn't know a lot about him. He looked good. I can't even say he was just executing the offense. Like, he played really well, similar to how Gardner Minshew in Jacksonville is playing really well. It's not just a guy who's dinking and dunking, he's throwing the ball downfield. I predicted coming into this game that Greg Olsen would have a bigger game, potentially get in the end zone a couple of times. He happened to do that this time. Good for Greg Olsen. When Cam Newton is in the lineup, Greg Olsen will continue to do well. It's good to know that if you own Greg Olsen on your team, or, you know, if you're looking to maybe, pick him up or in a trade or off waivers, if he happens to still be there. He's not going to be after this week, by the way. But he's going to be able to produce no matter what. Christian McCaffrey, a running back, always lightens the load. I always say for a young quarterback, their best friends are the running back, especially a pass-catching running back, and the tight end. And then that opens things up down the field. DJ Moore finally found the end zone, something I've been talking about for weeks. He's had opportunities, only one catch for 52 yards in that touchdown. He had been breaking free for quite a while. And then Curtis Samuel also got in the end zone, 5 catches on 7 targets and a touchdown, 53 yards. So what is that really saying to me if you read the stat line? I didn't really feel like it watched this way. The stat line tells me he's throwing short passes. The game tape tells me something a little different. I think he was kind of picking and choosing the shots. I think this is a team that was trying to kind of go after the shorter passing game, but I didn't think that they were limiting or handcuffing Kyle Allen. We'll see how that goes forward. It seems like Cam Newton is dealing with a Liz Frank injury. You know, those can be really tricky. It wouldn't honestly shock me if Cam Newton were to miss the rest of the season. It wouldn't shock me if he comes back soon. He's a tough guy, I know that. But the offense, I think, is in good hands. They'll be able to execute. And this team, they play tough defense. They always play tough defense, and I think they'll continue to do well. From a fantasy point of view, DJ Moore, you're probably not going to be able to get him. I don't really see a lot other than Greg Olsen. I do like him. I continue to like him in daily fantasy, and I like him regardless of who's throwing the ball in Carolina. They like to use that tight end. On the Arizona side, Kyler Murray didn't play particularly well to me, but he wasn't awful. He threw a couple interceptions, and he's just not going to win games. This team isn't good enough to overcome a couple of interceptions. 2 interceptions, 2 touchdowns, which is nice. Only 173 yards passing, so that short kind of passing game was on display once again. I guess the good news from a fantasy point of view, Christian Kirk and Larry Fitzgerald seem to still be scoring well. Now, Christian Kirk only had 59 yards, but he had 10 receptions. So if you're in a PPR league, shooting DraftKings, that's a 15.9. That's pretty darn good. You're going to want to get him in the end zone. Yes, I understand that. Larry Fitzgerald got in the end zone. David Johnson got in the end zone. Salvaged what was a bad day, because David Johnson only carried the ball 11 times for 37 yards. And what happens when, again, I've been saying this all season, I sound like a broken record, when Kyler Murray isn't having success throwing the ball downfield, which he didn't against the Carolina Panthers defense, it just bottles up David Johnson. And it's good for David Johnson owners that he got in the end zone. I was more optimistic having watched Arizona move the ball on Baltimore in Baltimore. But they kind of reverted back to, you know, kind of that week one type thing. And Carolina's defense, look, they're not the sexiest team in the world, but they always play good defense. And it was a tough sledding. And I'm just going to say this again, Kyler Murray's got to push the ball downfield. If he has limitations in that area, game to game, it's going to hurt David Johnson. But at least David Johnson is involved in the passing game. 9 targets, 6 catches in that touchdown. I don't see anything else from a fantasy point of view to really excite me on Arizona at this point. I'm sure Murray's owned by now in your league. I'm sure Christian Kirk and Larry Fitzgerald are owned, and then David Johnson. So I don't think that you should waste anything on Bird or Keyshawn Johnson or anything else like that. And then once again, just to kind of sum up for Carolina, if you can get your hands on Greg Olsen, I think that's a good idea. I do like DJ Moore. I do like Curtis Samuel. I think those guys have had a lot of opportunities. They've been behind defensive backs. So if they have a quarterback in Kyle Allen, or even if Cam comes back and can throw a little bit more accurately, there is more opportunity because, you know, they've left points on the board so far this season. So there's an episode of the Fantasy Football Fallout. I hope you check us out in another episode. I do every game every week. Like I said, I do watch every single play of every game so that I can figure out, I'm the guy who knows if a receiver got a lot of targets in the end zone but didn't come down with them, or if, you know, a long run was called back on a bad holding penalty or something like that. You don't get that everywhere else. So, you know, if you can, subscribe. We keep these videos short. And also, we're trying to grow our channel. We could use your support in that. If you could subscribe, that helps. If you could watch more videos, that helps too. I have a playlist in the upper right-hand side of all the Fantasy Football Fallouts, and we have archives. So check out our channel page and the playlists. You can also subscribe by hitting the lower right or the upper left, the logo or the red button. Both will get you there. So thanks a lot. Look for us in another episode, and talk to you then.